11 have announced before him, but none as brash, confident, bodacious, and unapologetic. The Donald is in.
I am officially running for President of the United States. Sadly, the American dream is dead. But if I get elected president, I will bring it back bigger and better and stronger than ever before, and we will make America great again.
That's the Donald. He also said, I'm really rich. In fact, it was just one of the observations made by the latest candidate to throw his hat into the presidential ring. And I think it was the most badass announcement today. By the way, what is really rich? Take the assets, subtract the liabilities, and you've got $9 billion. Donald Trump is now in the race. And I got to tell you, it's all about Machiavelli. Forget Dale Carnegie. First, he crushes his GOP foes, actually saying that one was so oblivious that he sweated like a dog when he announced. Then he calls out all the folks in Washington of all stripes, calls them losers, controlled by special interests. And then he threw down the gauntlet on China, Japan, Mexico. He promised new trade relationships and a southern wall. Also, he'll beat ISIS. He actually claims to be the best jobs president that God ever created. Lots of bravado. Will America buy it? Let's find out. All right, guys. I know everybody was glued to the screen today. I don't care what you tell me. Hi, I'm Charles Payne, and you're watching Making Money. Let's meet the investment pros tonight. Jim Awad, chairman of Plimsoll Mark Capital. He's back with us. Hillary Kramer, president and chief investment officer at A&G Capital. Jim Frischling, president of New Oak Capital. Matt McCall's back with us, founder and president of Penn Financial Group. He's really out. And Scotty Nell Hughes, TPNN.com news director, joins us from Nashville. Let's do it, guys. Let's dig into the first real deal. All right, Scotty, I got to start with you. You've been involved in politics for quite a while now. What do you make of Donald Trump's announcement?
I absolutely loved it, Charles. And whether or not you're going to go into the voting booth and vote for Trump, I guarantee at some point you had to go, yes, finally, somebody said that at his speech today. He kind of reminded me of the Rodney Dangerfield character from Caddyshack, where we've heard all these superficial, well-crafted political consultant speeches, and he came out and just spoke real truth, and people were excited to hear it. So I'm excited for him. I think he actually said what most conservatives, most Republicans have been yearning to hear.
So here's the thing, Hillary. If most conservatives, most Republicans have been yearning to hear it, how come the 11 candidates before him didn't say it?
Because it takes a lot of nerve and a lot of guts to be able to say, I'm rich, I'm really rich. It takes nerve to say that the Chinese leaders are like Tom Brady and that our American leaders are like high school football players.
Why? I don't understand. Why is it so tough to say that the China's running circles around us, that they own $1 trillion of our debt? Why is that so difficult to say?
Because even though it's the truth, it's hard for everyone to hear because we do all believe and see that we are the best country in the world. I mean, we're not harvesting in China, if you get out of favor, they harvest your organs and kill you. Okay.
Yeah, but we've been patting ourselves on the back for a long time, right, Hillary? And the fact of the matter is that things have shifted. And he also admitted today he sold a $15 million apartment to China.
Yes.
You can't deny their success. He tried not to diss him too much. But, you know, overall, Scotty's point, where has this fire been? Or was it just too apolitical to ever get elected?
I think it's too political to ever get elected. And I think, look, it was entertaining. It was a lot of fun. If you're in this thing for a sprint, then you can have a great time sprinting. But if you're in this for the marathon, you want to win the GOP nomination.
So he won the sprint. He won a 40-yard dash.
I'm saying he's going to win a 40-yard dash here, and that's not going to be much more. But again, it was entertaining. He's going for the no political experience bit. But you know what? Bloomberg was able to do that for the mayoral election in New York. Okay, but even he couldn't play that on the main stage. And again, I don't think this goes.
But it's a circus. I mean, you can't take this seriously. And Scotty mentioned the truth. We came out and say he's worth $9 billion. Forbes already came out and refuted that, say he's actually worth $4.1 billion. You know why? He says his brand's worth $3 billion. Everybody else says it's worth $200 million.
Well,
I mean, he's
all fairness, though, come on, $4 billion, $9
billion.
You can just about buy anything you want.
I love that he's rich and I love that he's been successful. But the thing is, it just shows the type of person he is. He's grandiose. He blows things up out of proportion. He's not telling the truth.
For a nation whose greatness has died, Scotty, before you get in, let me bring Jim Awad in because, Jim, this is what I want to ask. Trump spent a lot of time talking about the world, right? He almost declared economic war on the rest of the world. And it's interesting because he talked about creating jobs and mostly bringing jobs and money back from China. The position that he wants to take, would it actually work? Could we declare economic war on the rest of the world and survive?
No, absolutely not.
Why not?
We're indebted to them. First of all, we need them to make things that we buy, and we sell them our debt. Look, the world is not black or white. It's nuanced. And he's coming in there with one-liners that are entertaining, that are not applicable to the real world. And what I'm afraid of is he's going to go after and denigrate the other very reasonable Republican candidates, and they're going to cannibalize each other like they did, so that Romney, by the time he got to the election, was a weakened candidate. So I think there's downside.
What do you think, Scotty?
Well, that's the thing, Jim. That's the great news in all this. First of all, you say lack of leadership, lack of government experience. Hello, have we looked at the Oval Office for the last 8 years? That's what an entertainer-in-chief looks like. But what Donald Trump, I agree with you to a certain extent, Jim, in the fact that he is going to get in there, but I think he's only going to have one target, and that's going to be Jeb Bush. That's why I think it's really good he's in this race. I think he's going to be the one, because he doesn't care. He's going to sit there, and I think he's going to throw all of his daggers at Jeb and basically shield all these other candidates.
And then he's going to get Hillary. He's going to get Hillary as a result.
Exactly. Well, no, but that's the thing. It's not. That's the problem. If we have Jeb, we're going to get Hillary.
Well, here's the thing.
So I think we're going to give a chance.
Scotty, let me jump in, because here's the one thing also. It's one thing in the business environment to be able to do the things that Donald Trump talks about, the bureaucracy, the red tape, the built-in inefficiencies of Washington, D.C. I mean, no matter how great the game plan is, could it even matter? Could we actually have a businessman or woman turn this country around when everyone else might be a knucklehead?
I think if it's a businessman like Donald Trump who doesn't give a care, whose puppet strings are not being pulled by other people, who has more money than God, basically, as he said in his speech today, where he's going to go in there and say, I don't care what you think. I'm going to do what's right. So in that case, yes, I think so. He's different from some of the other folks who might not be able to have that same gravitas.
Well, here's the thing, Hillary. I got to tell you, I'm not dismissing Donald Trump's bid out the gate. I think that's very premature. The leading GOP candidate has 12%, right? 12 and 13%. It is a wide open field. Donald Trump said things today that people feel. And here's the one thing I think was interesting. Everybody hates Washington, D.C., but they send back their own elected representative. Donald Trump is actually, in my mind, challenging people to not be the same. You know, listen, you know Washington does not work. It's time to really, really do this the right way. Not send someone who's had no sort of managerial experiences, you know, like President Obama, but someone who's overcome a lot of things. We know that, and all that would be brought out. I think it's too early to dismiss him.
Well, but Donald Trump, though, is really ultimately about the Donald Trump brand. Hopefully, if he could turn that into being about America, he should be in the White House. No question about it. But he's never been able to do that.
Well, we'll see.